We got cabs for days up in here, Essay.
Thank you. What are you doing in there? Quit wasting time and get back on the set. Our zombie stunt team is getting restless.
Happier to see this damn place.
Continue bleeding. More bleeding. More bleeding. And scene.
I was at the height of my career when my wife Alexandra gave birth to her. She was born Winona Lee Wyler, and I fell in love with her from the moment I laid eyes on her. Problem was, with so much going on with my new film company, Alexandra raised our little girl almost entirely by herself.
Thank goodness those tokens work. I was kind of tripping for a second, eh? That's a nice little shortcut.
Willard, please calm down. I'm only trying to help here. He wouldn't listen to me. Even Winona agreed that selling off the assets was the only way not to lose everything. He refused to hear a word of it. With the company. Blood-sucking debt collectors.
Out, it was like we studied it. There was something really badass about the way that we used to sit around and talk about what kind of sequels we'd make, how we'd kill everyone off, who would show their tits, all that kind of shit.
Willard Wyler we were talking about here. When we arrived at the theater.
Now that's G'd up.
This world is quite magical, isn't it? The decor just reeks of death, misery, and suffering. Certainly my kind of place.
We always played it safe, because we knew the tabloids would have a field day. The phone was still turned up. In the afternoon they did. I received a message that I was to see Mr. Wyler on his trip immediately. The photos he threw on the desk in front of me. Possibly damaged the film. Willard assured me that he could make this all go away.
We got caps for days up in here, S.A.